meticulous notes because I come prepared. Hey you, what up? Welcome to my channel or welcome back. I'm Mariam. In today's video, I am going to be ranking and counting down the best foundations of 2021 so far. We are almost halfway through the year and I have been testing all these foundations. I have been wear testing them. And so essentially this video is going to be a very thorough opinion on all the new foundations that just recently came out. So the way that I'm going to conduct this countdown is starting from 10 and going down all the way to the number one slot, which is my favorite foundation for the year thus far. Keeping in mind that probably about 6 or 7 of these foundations are definitely amazing. The rest are good or okay, but a pinch problematic. Either they're not meant for my skin type or perhaps they had some issues with them. I'll also be talking about some foundations that did not make the cut, unfortunately, so be sure to watch this video in its entirety. My skin type is oily AF. I am also somewhat acne prone, more acne prone in the winter months than in the summer months, although I do have a couple of breakouts here right now, but you probably can't really tell because I am wearing my favorite foundation for the year on my face. Go ahead and guess what it is, just for fun. So that's pretty much it for the intro. Are you here for it? I'm here for it. If you are, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, leave your comments down below. Of course, hit that notification bell so you can see all of my Wednesdays and Sundays videos. And if you are not subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe because we are a friendly fam. Let's count down these best foundations of 2021 thus far. Okay, so the first foundation that I want to talk to you guys about is unfortunately no longer in my possession because although it's a really nice foundation, sadly, it did not work for my oily AF skin type. I'm talking about the LYS foundation. So LYS Beauty is the first black-owned clean beauty brand at Sephora. I personally know the owner. She is an amazing person. She's a friend of mine. And this foundation was something that seemed so promising to me. The ingredients are super clean. It's affordable, $22. It's available at Sephora. There's a multitude of shades. Even when I applied this foundation on, the shade match was so exact and just so flattering and so beautiful on my skin that I was ready to rave about it until I conducted the wear test. And sadly, all the clean ingredients just did not work for my very oily skin. Because of all of these factors, the new clean LYS foundation is in the number 10 slot for me. Great foundation, beautiful shade match, love what the brand stands for and everything that it's trying to accomplish, but sadly, this product was not for me. But however, if you are a dry or normal skin type, I think you will love this one. In the number 9 slot is a foundation that almost didn't make the cut, but it did make the cut because a lot of people really love it. So I am talking about the Morphe Filter Effect Foundation. So this one is really inexpensive at $20. It's formulated with hyaluronic acid. So technically, my oily AF skin should be loving it. However, let's just put it this way. I didn't love it as much as everyone else loved it. This product was so overhyped AF that I was expecting a lot. Also, the price is right. I like the fact that there were so many different shades, so many different undertones. I guess because of all the hype, my expectations failed me. That's what happened. Not that it's a bad foundation, not that I hated it by any means. I liked it, I just didn't love it. So the thing with this one is you have to have absolutely really good, almost flawless skin in order for this to work. I am someone who has some texture, I'm someone who has bumps, I break out on occasion, and because of that, me and this foundation were not so friendly. It was just a bit texture enhancing on me. However, it did have a really great wear test. Me and my oily skin loves hyaluronic acid, so that did work out. It's water-based, has some dimethicone and talc as the third ingredient. Would I reach for it? Yeah, clearly I would, because I kept it. It wasn't in my fails list, but would I reach for it every day? No, I wouldn't. I would reach for it on like the best skin day possible, but then again, why would I want to do that if we have options in 2021? You know what I'm saying? But Like I said before, a lot of people do like this one. This is why it is in my number 9 slot. Moving right along and down the list. So now we're actually sliding into the category of foundations and tinted moisturizers, skin tints that I really like. So in the number 8 slot, we have the new Makeup Forever Water Tone Skin Perfecting Fresh Foundation Tint. Now this product is quite pricey at $37. So I know $37 isn't like pricey. It's not overpriced, but for something that is technically in the skin tint or tinted moisturizer category, I feel like $37 is a lot. I would pay $37 for a full coverage foundation, but not necessarily for a skin tint. Do you see what I'm saying? So now some facts about this skin tint. Best for combo, dry, normal skin, but it had a really great wear test on my oily skin and I kind of liked it. Even though it was very sheer, it looked perfecting on the skin. It gave me a nice veil, but didn't make it look like I was wearing any makeup. So all of these factors I really did enjoy. Also, this has 94% natural ingredients. I guess this is what the LYS foundation was trying to be like, but it just didn't work on my oily skin. This, however, works on my oily skin, but like I said, it is kind of pricey for a very sheer skin tint. I will say this has a little bit more than 1 ounce like most foundations. This is 1.35 fluid ounces, and it's also made in France. Moving right along to foundation in the number 7 slot. Are you ready? In the number 7 slot, we have L'Oreal Skin Paradise Water Infused Tinted Moisturizer. This one is $17. That's kind of nice. Doesn't have like a ton of shades, but surprisingly, light 01 and light 03 both work for me, which is also kind of surprising, meaning that there is nothing lighter than me in this shade range, but it wears really well. This is 70% water infused, oil free, looks really, really pretty on the skin, almost like a high-end tinted moisturizer. Another problem with this product, and this is the reason why it's in my number 7 slot, I gotta read this to you. This L'Oreal Skin Paradise uses N-sulazole. So this is a sunscreen ingredient that only offers UVB protection, but not UVA. If you're thinking of getting this product for SPF purposes, think again. You will still need to use a broad spectrum SPF with this product. Although it does say that it offers SPF 19, this ingredient, N-sulazole, unfortunately does not offer UVA protection. So you won't be as safe under the sun as you think. All right, so from the looks of it, it seems like I haven't really loved any of the foundations that I've mentioned so far, but trust me, my mood will change as of this next foundation. In the number 6 spot, we have NARS Pure Radiant Tinted Moisturizer Broad Spectrum SPF 30 Sunscreen. Now this is a great little tinted moisturizer. I like it a lot. So now this is water-based. Second ingredient is dimethicone, which is a silicone, but it does allow for that smoothing type of effect on your skin to take place. It also is infused with vitamin C, which helps with brightening your overall complexion. So that's another nice thing. 1.9 fluid ounces, okay? So almost double the size of most foundations, but it is a little pricey. $45 for the squeezy tube. But the great thing about this product, and the reason why I love it so much, is because it wears so well. It looks really good. It has super clean ingredients. I believe they use less than 1% synthetic fragrance, which is amazing and almost unheard of. But this is great. And I like it slightly better than the Makeup Forever Water Tone because it does offer that SPF protection. So although the coverage is kind of similar, sheer, not really too buildable. They essentially do the same thing. This one does just a little bit more. Also, I know it's a lot pricier than the L'Oreal Skin Paradise, but it does not use that shady ingredient for the sunscreen. This one actually uses titanium dioxide and actinoxate as the active ingredients to prevent a sunburn. Those are the facts on the NARS skin tint. Number five. Okay, so now this product went viral and for a good reason. Talking about the e.l.f. Camo CC Cream color correcting, full coverage, natural finish, collagen, peptides, plus niacinamide or niacinamide, broad spectrum SPF 30 sunscreen, CC cream, or foundation. This is so full coverage. This rivals some of your super full coverage foundations. And it's only $14 and you can get it at Target. Are you kidding me? Active ingredients are actinoxate, titanium dioxide, just like in the NARS product. Also, it uses some zinc oxide for the sunscreen. So this does a lot for very little money. It looks beautiful on the skin, like full coverage AF, very glam looking, but not makeup-y, not super cakey, kind of pretty, I will say, kind of still natural, if you will. It's an active ingredient is water, so it's also water-based. I don't know, it wears really well on my oily AF skin. A lot of people swear by it. It's very inexpensive. I mean, it's good for a reason. Do you agree or disagree? Comment down below. Number 4, Bobbi Brown Skin Long Wear Weightless Foundation SPF 15 Full Cover Oil-Free Shine Control. This guy, I've been reaching for a lot lately because I like it a lot. It's super smoothing on textured skin like mine, especially in those days when I have breakouts or large open pores or if I'm underslept. This definitely perfects the skin. This definitely gives it that nice, beautiful veil. It doesn't look too glammy. It still looks very natural. You can sheer it down to make it look a little bit more everyday or a little bit more natural. Like, let's say you want your freckles to play. I think this is a very, very flexible formula, great foundation. Let's go into some facts. $49, medium matte finish, SPF 15, long wearing, water-based, very smoothing. This also contains some natural mineral powders to control oil, which is probably why my skin loves it so much and why it wears so well on me. Has a nice pump, nice glass packaging, great foundation. I love it. Yeah, kind of pricey at $49, but really not much to complain about. Ah, there is one thing. It's the scent, you guys. This is very fragrant. So if you are someone who's not into scents, this might be too much for you. It smells like eucalyptus or something spa-like. It's very soothing scent, but a scent nonetheless. I know a lot of people may be allergic to scents or maybe it tends to break you out. I don't know. It doesn't do the same for me, but I have to call it out. If you are not into scents, don't reach for this one. This one is fragrant, but I love it. By the way, all these foundations that I'm talking about, I will be linking and listing down below in the description, and I will also link each individual foundation's video review plus the wear test, so you can check out those individual videos if you are interested in a particular one. Are we down to number 3? We are down to number 3, you guys. In the number 3 slot, we have the new Fenty Beauty Ease Drop Skin Blurring Tint. Now, this to me is kind of like a foundation slash skin tint hybrid because it's a lot more pigmented than just the tinted moisturizer. It offers a lot more coverage. Your shade match must be exact in order for it to look the best, in order for it to look natural. But it does give the skin a really nice soft focus type of effect. Excuse me, kind of blurs your imperfections, but not in a heavy foundation masky type of way. It does it in a very natural way. So I really, really like this product. I've been reaching for it a lot. It's very lightweight. It doesn't feel heavy or greasy on the face. It wears pretty well. Not like super amazing, but pretty damn well. Shades are great. The shade that I wear is 10 and it matches my 290 Fenty Beauty foundation. I love the packaging. Easy to travel with. Cute little squeezy tube. $29.50 available at Sephora. Tons of shades. Just like a great product. It works not just for the oily gals like me. I think it also works for normal to dry to combo skin, mature skin. It's just a very, very flexible product. Go Fenty. You did that. Also, water-based. Dimethicone is its second ingredient, I believe, so it does give that skin blurring effect. All right, in the number 2 slot, I have a product, a foundation, a skin tint rather, that's actually not from 2021, but the reason why I included it in this countdown and this roundup video is because I feel like it is very current, even though it came out like 4 or 5 years ago. It's very relevant to today and the kind of makeup that we're looking for today. I am talking about Bare Minerals Complexion Rescue Tinted Hydrating Gel Balm. Now, this also has broad spectrum SPF 30. It's a nice, reliable product for the summertime. It goes on kind of like a mousse, feels not so much like a gel the way that they describe it, but more like a moussey type of finish. The shade shade ginger that I wear goes on kind of peachy at first, but then it oxidizes yellow, so it matches me great, actually, surprisingly. What I love about this one is that it wears extremely well. It looks very perfecting on the skin. It's very sheer, but it's blurring, it's smoothing, and it just does a lot to play up the natural good parts of your skin. So although not for a day when I'm breaking out some type of bad, but definitely for my good skin days where I wanna play up my freckles, where I wanna feel like me, but just a little bit better, this is a keeper, you guys. This is a summertime keeper, and I'm so glad that I was able to sort of rediscover it this year in 2021. I love it, I can't put it down. I keep reaching for it. I keep wanting to use it every day. So the cool thing about this product is that this year in 2021, they've added more shades, and they also added a mini version, which is a lot cheaper. This full size is $33, I believe, and the mini is $15 or maybe $19. Pop up the right price right here. So it's nice, great to travel with, great to just keep in your makeup bag for touch-ups or on the go. I'm a fan. Also, I love the fact that this is a 3-in-1 product. So not only is it a skin tint, it's also an SPF and a moisturizer. So basically, it does everything at once. You don't even need a primer with this one. That's how good it is. Honestly, I'm obsessed. You can see my mood is kind of elevating. It's getting better the closer we get to my number one foundation that I am wearing on my face right now. If you guessed it, you are a real MVP and you watch my videos, and I see you and I appreciate you. In the number one slot of the best foundation of 2021 so far is Catrice. Catrice True Skin Hydrating Foundation with Hyaluronic Acid. I absolutely love this foundation. I am wearing it right now on my face. It looks so good. Natural, but fully covered. Doesn't look like foundation. It doesn't look like a mask. It is just a gorgeous, gorgeous formulation, you guys. The best part about this foundation is that it costs $11. $11 for this Luxie AF feeling foundation? Are you kidding me? I am going to stock up, and so should you. Links below. You're welcome. I mean, this is the one that I can't rave about enough. It says that it's a medium buildable coverage, but it feels more like a full to me, a full coverage that can be sheared out, which is kind of what I did here in the cheekbone area, because this is where I have my freckles that I really like and I don't want to cover them up. In fact, I want to play them up. So you could easily just use a lighter stroke with your brush or not apply as much foundation, but it blends out so seamlessly and so naturally and just so flawlessly that it just becomes one with your skin. Super skin perfecting, super pore friendly, super texture friendly. Hyaluronic acid and oily skin are besties, as we've learned, as I've learned throughout all these years of testing foundations. Also, it is water-based, cruelty-free, vegan, gluten-free, paraben-free, alcohol-free. I mean, what more do you want? This is definitely my favorite foundation of the year so far. It's the one that I've been wearing when I want to be a little bit more glam but still look kind of natural but look flawless and look really well put together. It just does that for me. The shade that I wear is 046 Neutral Toffee, so I will say that their neutrals lean a little bit more olive and a little bit more golden than their warms, which tend to lean more orange. So keep that in mind. But overall, I gotta say this is just a slam dunk product for me. I love this one more than the e.l.f. Camo CC Cream because the full coverage on this one is a pinch too full. It's like a pinch too dry on the skin. You actually feel it, you know? Whereas this is very, very lightweight. But both of these are exceptional products. This one is even cheaper than this one, but this one does contain some SPF. Basically, I just reach for this one more because it makes me feel better. But both of these, I really love. I don't know who is trying to interrupt my video with all these notifications. Simmer down. Now, before I go into the foundations that did not make the cut, I kind of want to compare all the ones that I just talked about to each other, why I like one more than the other. You already know the deal between these two. The reason why I like this one slightly more than this one is because of the price. They essentially do the same thing. Both have SPF, but this one has higher SPF. This one has SPF 15, but the price points, you know, the price point is what makes the difference for me here. Now, the Fenty, I'm not going to include with the full coverage foundations because it's technically not a full coverage product. It's more like a medium buildable, definitely fuller than most skin tints, but nowhere near as full as these guys. So this one's kind of in a category of its own. I can't really compare it to anything else. The Bare Minerals I like slightly more than the Fenty because I feel like it's just like a one and done. This is really easy. If you're having a really good skin day, you can just reach for it. It gives you the SPF, it gives you a little bit of coverage, gives you a little bit of blurring, gives you a little bit of perfecting. Whereas the Fenty, although still kind of nice, although still gives you the skin blurring, it does not have the SPF and your shade has to match exactly. You can't just like wing it with this one. Like it has to be a good shade match in order for it to work. So the NARS is also, like I said, very, very good, but on the pricey side, very clean, clean ingredients, wears really well, has a ton of shades, but you know, we got options. We got a $45 option, then we got a $29.50 option, that's a little bit more full coverage, and then we also have the $33 option, so like $33 or $45. All right, and now let's get into some foundations and some tinted moisturizers that did not make the cut that I did not love. I didn't want to start with these products because I didn't want to start off negative. I'd rather like wrap with some negative commentary. Some products that did not make the cut. I actually don't have any of these any longer because I gave them away. They obviously didn't work for me. Basically in no particular order. The Urban Decay Hydromaniac Tinted Moisturizer did not work for me. Now granted, this was not meant for oily skin. This was meant for drier skin types, but after conducting my wear test on this product, after testing it out, after conducting a review, I was reading the commentary under the video and a lot of people were saying that even with their dry skin types, they were just not loving this Hydromaniac product. Just not a hit for me and not a hit for a lot of people. And I really wanted to love it because this was a dewy product that came out. It was $29, so fairly inexpensive. I wanted it to work, you know, but it didn't. Next, another foundation that did not make the cut this time is the Huda Beauty Faux Filter Luminous Foundation. So now this one was supposed to be the new and improved version to Huda's original Faux Filter Foundation, but this one was kind of like the dewy luminous sister of it. However, after conducting the wear test and the review of this product, I didn't really see any difference between the original and the new and improved version. Moreover, my little brother came in for a little cameo in that video and he basically did not have anything nice to say about the way that my face was looking that day. He said that this foundation made my skin look like I was wearing 100 layers of wax, that it looked very fake, that emphasized all of my little crinkles, made my skin look basically worse than what it does. So I did not love hearing that, and because of his commentary, I actually never reached for that foundation ever again. And also, I kind of stopped wearing the original Huda Beauty Faux Filter Foundation. It just didn't sit right with me, you know? I don't want to look like a wax statue. I don't want to look like I'm wearing 100 layers of wax on my face. Also, it's kind of a pricey foundation at $40. So after that moment, I just decided to say no altogether. But damn, to think about it, I actually would wear that foundation for like my glam nights and I would feel very well put together in my wax face. You live and you learn. Another foundation that did not make the cut was the Essence Pretty Natural Foundation for $7. I wanted to love it because I am absolutely obsessed with Essence's tinted primer. I've recommended it so many times here on my channel. So once they came out with this Pretty Natural Foundation, I was certain that it was gonna be a great product. Unfortunately, it had a tragic wear test. It had a $7 wear test, basically. So I'll just leave it at that. It didn't work for me, but I wanted it to. The Milk Makeup Sunshine Tint at $42 was honestly a little offensive at that price point. I feel like Milk is one of those brands that really caters to Gen Z, to the younger demographic, but their price points are absolutely ridiculous for that demo, so I don't really get it. Moreover, I didn't like the product. I felt like the little roll-on deodorant applicator was really crazy and weird. The product itself felt very balmy and just too sheer for me. So I guess there is an audience for it. I guess Gen Zs who like to spend $42 on a skin tint, but I would skip that one altogether. Didn't impress me. And last but not least, you guys, and this is a product that I'm still keeping because it's a very recent fail. I'm talking about the Laura Mercier Tinted Moisturizer Oil-Free Natural Skin Perfector with Broad Spectrum SPF 20 Sunscreen. This product. It's streaky AF, you guys. I really, really tried to make it work. I tried to make it work with different primers underneath, with different powders on top, and it was just a hot ass mess. It was so streaky. It was really difficult for me to get it to look flawless. It just was not sitting right on my skin. Moreover, I'm kind of disappointed because I really wanted to like it. It's very pricey at $46 for a skin tint. So if you're oily like me, I wouldn't recommend it. Perhaps maybe if you have normal, really good skin, maybe it'll work for you, but it was just too problematic for me and really, really overpriced. So that is it for all the foundations that I have tried this year that I have loved and also those that did not work for me. I hope you guys liked this roundup video. Let me know if you want to see these conducted on other products, perhaps not necessarily foundations, maybe some eyeshadow palettes or other products. Let me know. I'm all ears. And also tell me what are some of your favorites from the year. Maybe I've missed something. Maybe you don't agree with me. Maybe you do agree with me. Let's talk. Let's start a conversation. I am going to zoom on out so that you can check out my other videos. Click on them. You know you ain't got nothing better to do. I love you guys. Mwah. Peace.